As Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada ki Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya Acharya Guru Varki Ananta Koti Vaishnavrinda ki Jai Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bol 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 Aradhya Bhagwan Vrajesh Tanayas Taddham Vrindavanam Ramya Kachidupasana Vrajavadu Vargena Taya Kalpita Shrimat Bhagavata Purana Yamalam Prema Pumartho Mahan Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhor Mataidam Nayatrayagraha Para Vandeham Shri Guru Shri Yuta Padakamalam Shri Guru Vaishnavamscha Shri Rupam Sagrajatam Sahagana Raghunathanvitam Tamsa Jivam Sadadvetam Savadutam Parijana Sahitam Sri Krishna Chaitanya Devam Shri Radha Krishna Padan Sahagana Lalita Vishakhan Vitamscha Navanirada Nindita Kanti Dharam Rasho Shagar Nagar Bhupavaram Shubha Vanki Macharu Shikhanda Shikhim Bhaja Krishna Nidhim Vrajaraj Sutam Radhika Sarodayindu Nindimukha Mandali Vandiye Shripada Padma Vrishabhanu Nandine Vandiye Shripada Padma Vrishabhanu Nandine Vandiye Shripada Padma Vrishabhanu Nandine Vancha Kalpataru Vishcha Kripa Sindhu Vyevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha It's just so nice to be home. Although Chaitanya Kishore Prabhu announced that I'm from Canada, but I'm here from New Seva Kunj. That's my identity. About 34 years ago, that's where the journey started. Right here at this temple. And this is indeed my home. And I'm very grateful to the ISKCON temple management to engage me in the service of speaking about Krishna consciousness, and especially today's subject matter, because of the month. December is typically our book marathon month, book distribution. transcendental book distribution. And perhaps I can kind of glorify how important it is, by the mercy of Sri Sri Guru and Gauranga, the sublime process which will give us the highest benefit of our existence. We are so used to, right from our childhood, from the preschool days to kindergarten, and then the second, third, fourth, fifth grade, middle school, high school, undergraduation, graduation, bachelor's, master's, and for some further, they pursue education in different fields. And we all know that books are the basis, even for the material education. So what to talk about when we speak about a science? The Vedas are in Sanskrit. I'm sure I see a lot of the devotees here from the Indian background, and they've heard the word Vigyan. So Vigyan is actually a Sanskrit word, which is a combination of two words. Vishesha Gyan Iti Vigyan. Vishesh means very special or topmost knowledge. Vishesh Gyan. And what is Vishesh Gyan? Vishesh Gyan is the science of self-realization, the science of our connection with the Supreme Lord. That is the topmost knowledge. Vishesh Gyan, special knowledge. And Srila Prabhupada, His Divine Grace, said four wonderful things that are all interconnected. Books are the basis. Preaching is the essence. Purity is the force. And utility is the principle. We find that even most faiths in this existence, they all believe in the book, whatever book they are following. Like the Christians, they call it the Word of God, the Bible. So similarly, the Vedas say, Dharmantu Sakshat Bhagavat Pranitam. In the sixth canto, there is a wonderful discussion between Yamraj and his servants, the Yamduts, especially in the third chapter, this verse, where Yamraj is, who is one of the most important devotees of Lord Krishna, the 12th, he is a Mahajan. Dharmasya tattva nihitam guhyam mahajana jena gathasapantaha. The principles of religiosity are confidential in nature. And somebody may say, why is it confidential? Because unless and until we get information about the supreme or the divine in the spiritual realm, Lord Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, all this information is obtained from those personalities who have seen them, who have experienced, who have personally rendered seva to the Supreme Lord, Sri Krishna. I think somebody's phone is very active, so I would appreciate it if you all can mute your or put it on mute. That way, I have the tendency to get distracted. It is my weakness, so please forgive me. So, one time in Kolkata, Srila Prabhupada's Gurudev, as we see, he's right there on that wall, is Divine Grace Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. He was told by some business people that the way you're preaching so forcefully and so much with so much vigor, it seems that everybody will become a devotee, and then will you have room for them in the temple? Will you have enough prasadam? So he said, I will bring one brick from Vaikuntha and that will cover all the cost. Also, His Divine Grace Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur, when he was asked, how do we know about Krishna, about the divine personalities and the avatars of the Supreme Lord, when we are not able to see them? A natural question that people may have. So he said that one can see God, or one can see Krishna, by the process of hearing from a pure soul. Because he has descended from that spiritual sky, from Golok Vrindavan, from Vaikuntha Loka, and he is able to give us information of a distant place or a distant land. Just like we find in our own experience, supposing if we have not visited a certain country in a certain part of the world, and we have a friend who has visited it, and they say, oh, we just went to this beautiful place, and they start describing the seas and the beautiful skies and the environment of that particular place. And just by hearing about that place, we perhaps get attracted that, okay, my next vacation, I would like to be there. So similarly, we are very fortunate if we can hear from those perfected souls who have descended from the spiritual world. Namaum Vishnupadaya Krishna Preshthaya Bhutale. Every day, thousands and thousands of devotees recite Prabhupada's Pranam Mantra. And in Srila Prabhupada's Pranam Mantra, the very first line gives us an indication. What is that indication? That one who is so dear to Sri Krishna has descended from the spiritual world, meaning Golok Vrindavan, to this material world. And he has brought information about that distant land, about that transcendental, that divine land, out of pure compassion for the fallen souls. And not only that, knowledge can be obtained. Our Vedas say, Vedas means knowledge itself, the word Veda. And Veda is divided into material knowledge and spiritual knowledge. And obviously spiritual knowledge is Vijnanam or Visheshajnana, topmost knowledge that gives us the information that we are not these bodies, we are the spirit soul. And there is a soul and a super soul. And the super soul is an expansion of the Supreme Personality of Godhead Sri Krishna. And our connection, our yoga is with Sri Krishna. And when we are connected to the Supreme, then the perfection of our existence is attained. And when we are not connected, then we are continuously suffering what Krishna describes in the Bhagavad Gita, Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadhi Dukkha Dosha Anudarshanam. Birth, death, old age and disease. And in between, a lot of other problems that we find in this material world, because that is the characteristic of the material world. And there is a place known as Vaikuntha. Sanskrit in meaning of Vaikuntha, Vai means no, and Kuntha means anxiety. the land of no anxiety, where there is no birth, there is no death, there is no old age, and there is no disease. There is no adhyatmik, adibhautik, and adidaivik kleshas. There are no miseries there. Time comes to a standstill. Everything is now. Nothing is subject to decay. Everybody is full of youth, just like the Supreme Lord. And everybody, all the living entities, are in full of bliss in the service of either the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna, or any of his incarnations or avatars. So knowledge, last week Nityanand Pran Prabhu gave a wonderful presentation on knowledge. So knowledge, according to the Vedas, there are three ways one can obtain knowledge. The first way is known as Pratyaksha Praman. Pratyaksha means whatever we can perceive with our senses. With our senses. So my eyes, if I can see something, I believe it. My ears, whatever I hear, I believe. And etc. The nose. Pratyaksha. Aksha means actually eyes, but aksha also represents all senses. So seeing is believing. That's what most people in this material world are adept to, and that's what they adopt. Otherwise, most people do not believe. So that's one way of acquiring knowledge. So yeah, okay. So for example, if I see that this is, example, a car is in front of me, I see it, and there's somebody tells me in my childhood that this is a car. So when I see, and then I can relate with other automobiles, this is a car or this is a bus, etc. So by seeing, by sense perception, I can acquire knowledge. That's one method. The second method is known as Anuman. Anuman means hypothesis. Hypothesis means experimentation. So we find today in modern science, in the school, colleges, research, etc., they said that there was a wonderful experiment performed, or nice experiment. R&D, research and development, is going on at the moment. Right? We find that. So in that experimentation, it is not necessary that every experiment is successful. That is why it is called experiment. It may be successful, it may not be successful. So out of that, some knowledge is derived due to experimentation. But it is not the most perfect. And then the third way to obtain knowledge is known as Shabda Praman. Shabda Praman means when one obtains knowledge through the perfect source just by hearing. Now out of the three, the third one, Shabda Praman, is considered the most effective and the most perfect. Why is that? Because the first one, sense perception or Pratyaksha Praman, has a limitation. For example, if I remove my glasses, I cannot read what's on the wall. There's the limitation. Or even if I have the perfect 20/20 eyesight, suddenly if there is a blackout, then my eyes are dependent on a concomitant factor known as light. But that does not mean that all these people who are seated there, or that Hare Krishna Mahamantra board that is printed on the wall, or the wonderful photographs of the divine graces, they do not exist. Or the Vyasasana of Srila Prabhupada doesn't exist. Suddenly there is a total pitch blackout. So my eyes, although I say seeing is believing, now I cannot see all of you, but it doesn't mean that you all do not exist. Right or wrong? So it is dependent on that factor. And then many such examples, and I'm sure the wonderful audience has understood the point about the defect of seeing is believing. In Anuman or hypothesis, there is a defect as well, because there is a lot of hypothesis speculation. A good example that I normally like to give is, supposing you are in your house, and let's say you are the only one as far as you are concerned, let's say your wife or your kids have gone out, and you are sitting, let's say, in your living room, and suddenly if you hear the garage door open, so you can conclude hypothesis that, oh, my wife has come back, so the garage door is open. But it could be a thief who has got access to your garage door. Right? Hypothesis. It could be not. Based on hypothesis. But Shabda Praman. Shabda Praman means when we hear whether material education or spiritual, and especially spiritual knowledge, when we hear it from a perfect source, then it is perfect. For example, I can talk about my personal myself. When I was only perhaps, I still remember, 2 or 3 years old, we had photographs of our grandfather and grandmother on the wall in our home. And my father used to say that, you know, your grandfather passed away when I was only 5 years, and your grandmother passed away when I was only 2 years. But if I say, well, I have not seen them, so I don't believe that they existed. So there, Pratyaksha Praman fails. But because it is the perfect source, my father saying that this is your grandfather, this is your grandmother, then my father has no reason to lie. He is always my well-wisher, practically speaking. So he's going to tell me the truth. And if I want the method of hypothesis, then I can take that photograph and go to every old person in the colony or in the town or the village and say, do you know if this is my grandmother? Do you know if this is my grandmother? And then the old person goes, I think it looks like your grandmother, but I'm not sure, my dear son. So their hypothesis fails. But when we get information through a perfect source, then we are most blessed. And not everybody is fortunate to get that perfect information. And therefore the Vedas say, Dharmantu Sakshat Bhagavat Pranitam. The word of God is perfect and it is Dharma. It is Dharma personified, Sakshat Bhagavat. Because the Krishna himself, the Supreme Lord, the holy name, his pastimes, his leela, his words, his paraphernalia, his dham, the holy places, are identical. They are non-different. Naam na naami no abhinna. So, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada was asked this question by one of his leading disciples. Just like we have katha discourses and then at the end there are question answer sessions. How can we believe that there is Krishna? How can we believe that there is all these spiritual planets? We have not seen it. It's not within our purview. It is not within our experience. So then Bhakti Siddhanta says, we can see it through the words of those who have descended from there, who are the associates of Sri Krishna, who are their intimate servitors, who bring information from a distant land. So therefore, we have to, the word of God is brought down by his true representatives. And of course, it is mostly for the benefit of man. The Vedas are also known as Shrutis. Shruti means to hear. To hear. And then the disciples of Vyasadeva, they wrote down what they heard from Guru. So Vyasadeva, talking about knowledge, especially transcendental knowledge, just like, you know, the reason why I'm inspired to speak about a little bit about the entire parampara is when we are honoring the Vyas Puja of Srila Prabhupada or any of our Gaudiya Acharyas, we glorify the entire parampara. So books are the basis, is right from the time immemorial. And for example, Vyasadeva, he compiled one Ved in the beginning known as the Rig Ved. It was so complicated that he further, for the benefit of mankind, divided the Vedas into three. Sam, Yajur and Atharva Vedas. And that was also so complicated that he actually sat in the assemble of his disciples and the audience and he started explaining the purports, the verses. And that is what was known as the Upanishads. Upanishad means sitting next to the Guru and listening the explanation. That is the meaning of the Upanishads. So the Upanishads were written by those who had heard from Guru Vyasadeva. Vyas means one who compiles. Vyas means one who expands. Because dharma or the process of religiosity is very complex. And the verses are there, but somebody needs to sit. And that is why this place is known as Vyas Asana. Whenever the speaker is speaking, he is actually representing Vyasadeva. He is expounding. Perhaps taking one verse from the Bhagavad Gita. Perhaps taking a verse from Srimad Bhagavatam. Or from any Vedic scripture. And then he expounds. He explains. And that is why it is known as Vyasa. Vyasa Katha. The speaker. Vyasa Asana. The seat where Vyasa, the representative of Vyasadeva, is sitting. So, the representatives who have heard in disciplic succession, they are the ones who have very attentively, they listened to the Guru. And because of their surrender to the Guru, they were able to import the true inner meaning of the purports of what Gurudev is speaking. Like for example, even in the Bible, it's the month of Christmas and the appearance of Lord Jesus Christ will be here very soon. And the Bible is known as the Word of God. And the Bible is divided into books that were actually compiled by the disciples of Jesus Christ, principally the 12 apostles. Like Luke, Mark, John, etc. So similarly, the disciples of Vyasadeva, they actually, whatever they heard, they compiled and then they presented it to the rest of the world for their benefit. And from Vyasadeva, as we are in this particular sampradaya, prior to Vyasadeva, actually, Krishna gave knowledge to Lord Brahma. Srimad Bhagavatam says, Tene Brahma Hridaya Adi Kavaye, the very first verse. Krishna imparted this knowledge, transcendental knowledge in the heart of the first poet, Brahmaji. And Lord Brahma compiled the famous Brahma Samhita, which we all are very, we know in ISKCON, along with so many other transcendental books. But one of the books is Brahma Samhita. After that, his disciple Naradji, he obtained the knowledge from Lord Brahma and he compiled also many wonderful scriptures, one of the most famous being the Narad Pancharatra, where he speaks about some of the most famous verses that Rup Goswami has imbibed in his works, like the Bhakti Rasam Sindhu. One that comes to my mind is, one of the words is that knowledge and even karma should be given up. Anukulyena Krishna Anushulanam Tad Bhaktir Uttama. Anya Bilashita Shunya Jnana Karma Navratam. Anukulyena Krishna Anushulanam Tad Bhaktir Uttam. That is considered the highest bhakti. When we give up even the tendency of knowledge, jnana, and even karma. And what is the positive thing that we can do? Anukulyena Krishna Anushilanam. That which pleases the Supreme Lord, that is Uttam Bhakti. Because then even in Sanatan Dharma or Hinduism, a lot of the people are into Shastra, reading the Vedas, reading the different scriptures. But ultimately, there is no bhakti within their hearts. There is no seva to Krishna, the Mayavadis, the Brahmavadis, etc. And the ultimate goal, Srimad Bhagavatam declares, Vasudeva Para Veda. The ultimate goal of even studying the Vedas is to know Sri Krishna. And if we cannot culminate loving devotional service to Krishna, it is Shrama Eva Hi Kevalam. It is time wasted. Naradji passed on into the heart of Vyasadeva, that transcendental knowledge, especially in the form of Srimad Bhagavatam. నిగమకల్పతరో గలితం ఫలం సుఖముఖా ద్రవం మృతం సంయుతం పిబత భాగవతం రసమాలయం ముహురహో రసిక భూమి భావుక. ది ట్రీ ఆఫ్ ద వేదాస్ నిగమకల్ప, విచ్ ఇస్ ది డిజైర్ ట్రీ, తరో ద ట్రీ, గలితం ఫలం శ్రీమద్ భాగవతం ఇస్ ది మోస్ట్ స్వీటెండ్ అండ్ రైపన్డ్ ఫ్రూట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ద వేదిక్ లిటరేచర్స్. సుఖముఖాద్ ద్రవ అమృత సంయుతం, బికాస్ ఇట్ ఎమినేటెడ్ ఫ్రమ్ సుఖ్. సుఖ్ మీన్స్ సుఖ్దేవ్ గోస్వామి, అండ్ సుఖ్ ఆల్సో మీన్స్ అ ప్యారెట్. ఎనీ ఫ్రూట్ దట్ హెస్ బిన్ టేస్టెడ్ బై ద ప్యారెట్, ద బీక్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్యారెట్, ఇట్ టేస్ట్ దట్ ఫ్రూట్, దట్ ఫ్రూట్ బికమ్స్ ఈవెన్ మోర్ నెక్టేరియన్. సో వేదాస్ ఆర్ నెక్టేరియన్, but because Sukhdev Goswami, there's a double meaning, the son of Vyasadev spoke Srimad Bhagavatam, it became even more sweeter, just like a parrot when it tastes a guava or a mango. Amongst all the mangoes that are sweet on the tree, one particular mango that has been dented with the beak of a parrot is the sweetest of all. So like this, books are the basis. Srimad Bhagavatam, Srimad Bhagavatam Mahamuni Krite Kim Va Pareshwar Ishwar Sadyo Avarudyate Atra Krutubi Shushrubi Tatshanat. Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, second verse. This Srimad Bhagavatam that has been compiled in maturity by Mahamuni Vedvyas, and Vedvyas himself says that there is no need for any other scripture. And once one studies Srimad Bhagavatam without any envy, and just the desire to serve Srimad Bhagavatam will itself, the service, the desire to serve Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavatam, Bhagavat means the book Bhagavat and the person Bhagavat. Ishwara sadhyo avaruddhate atra, one can arrest Sri Krishna in their heart instantly. Arrest means one can control Sri Krishna. Krishna is generally known as Bhakta Vatsal. And Vatsal means he is the provider for everyone. He's like we are children, like a calf. Actually in Sanskrit, Vatsa means calf. Or a child, or a kid. And whenever we are asking the Supreme Lord, O Lord, like Prabhupada says, the Christians pray, Dear Lord, give us thy daily bread. O Lord, thou art in heaven, give us thy daily bread. Or many, many people come to the temple and they pray to Sisi Kishore Kishori, my dear Sisi Kishore Kishori, you know, I have all these different material problems. Please help me with them. So Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, yes, I help them. Arthi, Artharthi, Jnani, Jigyasu, they come to me. And majority of the people are in that category. But for those who are pure devotion and pure bhakti, Krishna for them he transforms himself from Bhakta Vatsal to Bhakta Vashya. Krishna is controlled by them. Just like the Vrajvasis. They control every moment of Sri Krishna, every move of Sri Krishna. Bhakta Vashya. Krishna is controlled by his devotee. And that is the meaning in Srimad Bhagavatam when he says, that one has the sincere desire to serve Srimad Bhagavat or Bhagavat, the book Bhagavat or the person Bhagavat, Krishna can be controlled instantly by that devotee because they will obtain the highest devotion. Srimad Bhagavatam, just to take one book which is the most perfected out of the thousands and thousands of literatures that Vyasadeva has given, books are the basis. Vedanta Sutra, what does Vedanta mean? Ved plus Anta equals Vedanta. Ved means all the Vedas. Anta means conclusion. Most of you all who are from the vernacular Indian background, it's the same word. Most people in Hindi will say, Ant mein kya hua bataiye? Ant. What is the conclusion? To make the long story short. So that is Vedanta Sutras. Whereas they compiled those. Which is the pure Savai Pumsam Paro Dharmo Yato Bhakti Radokshaje Ahitukiya Pratiyata Jena Atma Suprasidati. Srimad Bhagavatam, The conclusion is that the ultimate dharma or duty of mankind is bhakti, service unto the Supreme Personality of Lord Goddess Sri Krishna. And it has to be ahaituki and apratiyata. Without any material motivation and apratiyata, it has to be uninterrupted. And the result is jena atma suprasidati. Then the self or the soul will be satisfied. And jena atma suprasidati also means that the super soul will be satisfied by that service. There's a double meaning. The Rasika Acharyas have explained that. What is the meaning of the word jena atma suprasidati? From Vyasadeva we move on. Books are the basis. In the disciplic succession and came down to Madhvacharya. And Sri Madhvacharya Pad has written so many wonderful bhashyas on the Bhagavad Gita. On different Upanishads. Bhashya means commentaries. And from Madhvacharya, it came down in disciplic succession to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, he is none other than Nandanandan Krishna, Radharaman Krishna, Gopi Jana Vallabha Krishna, Kishori Vallabha Krishna. From the original Supreme Personality of Godhead, Janmadi Yasya, from whom everything emanates. And he himself, taking the mood of Sri Radha, he appeared of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he composed the most fantastic poem in the form of Sistashtakam. The 8 verses. Prema Dhama Eva Naomi Gaur Sundaram. He is the abode of Prema. I offer my obeisances unto that Gauranga Mahaprabhu. And Namo Mahavadanyaya Krishna Prema Pradayate Krishna Krishna Chaitanya Namini Gaur Tishai Namaha. And in his final prayojan means the final goal. There are 3 stages in a devotee's life, or 3 stages per se, sambandha, relationship. We try to know who Krishna is, we try to know, and then that relationship, the process is known as abhidhyay, following the instructions of the acharyas. And then we ultimately, when we reach that goal is known as prayojan. So Krishna Nandan had also a prayojan. He had a final goal. And what was that goal? In the last 12 years of his life, he went into reclusion in a very small place in Jagannath Puri known as the Gambira. And there he did intense bhajan. He took Naam Ashraya of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra itself. Krishna himself takes Mahamantra. He continuously chants because he has a goal to attain. And what is that goal? To attain Radha Bhav. And when he finally attains that, this golden volcano of divine love, he bursts. And when a volcano bursts, what happens? There is golden lava. And that lava, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, the last chapter, Krishnaraj Kaviraj Goswami describes, it came out in the form of the Chaitanya Sistashtakam. Books are the basis. Sarvatam Damodar Goswami, who is none other than Lalita Sakhi, only 2 personalities. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was in reclusion in the Gambira. Sarvatam Damodar Goswami is Lalita Sakhi. Rai Ramananji is Vishakha Sakhi. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who had finally attained the bhav of Sri Radha, Sarut Damodar Goswami immediately wrote down what emanated from his mouth. Cheto Darpana Marjanam Bhavadava Mahagni Nirvapana Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitaranam Vidya Vadu Jivanam Ananda Vambudhi Vardhanam Pratipadapurna Amrita Swadhanam Param Vijayate Sri Krishna Sankirtanam, and etc. etc. Books are the basis. And the Sistastakam is that. Those 8 verses is the sanam, samam bonam of the highest bhakti, because that is the bhakti of Sri Radha in the Madhurya Rasa, in the Madanakya and the Mohanakya Bhav. We are all looking for Krishna Prem, but Krishna Prem has further many, many delineations. The Krishna Prem that the Sakhas of Krishna have is called Sambrama Prema, Vishrama Prema. And then the Prema that Mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba has is known as Grutta Sneha. And the prema that the gopis in the Madhuri Rasa and the conjugal rasa, it is further delineated into five special categories: Raga, Anuraga, etc. And especially the final and that summum bonum of the highest Krishna prema, which is the exclusivity of Sri Radha, is Madanakya and Mohanakya prema. Nobody can attain that, which Krishna himself attained in the bhava of Sri Radha, taking the shelter of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So it is so important to understand this point, that this Mahamantra is for everyone. It is just not for the someone who has just been introduced to Krishna consciousness, but it is also for the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Sri Krishna himself has taken ashram. Books are the basis, and when we read the books of the Acharyas, we come to know about these things. And that is what His Divine Krishna Prabhupada gave us. It further came down to the six Goswamis of Vrindavan. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave special siksha to Rupa and Sanatan Goswamis. Rupa Goswami has written wonderful rasic and philosophical Bhakti Rasamsindhu, Vigda Madhava, the Padyavali. So many different books they have given us. Sanatan Goswami has given Bhrut, Bhad, Bhagat, Amrita. He has given us Hari Bhakti Vilas, just to name a couple, running out of time. That tells us. And the most important thing is all these personalities, including Srila Prabhupada, they give us information about that distant land. And that is how we take darshan. That is how, although we cannot see now, but we can hear and we can develop that bhav. Raghunath Das Goswami, Vilab Kasum Manjali, was one of Mukta Charita, Manasiksha, Jiva Goswami, Sharasandharbas, Gopala Champu. It came down in disciplic succession, down to Narottam Das Thakur. Many, many works. The prominent Prarthana, Prem Bhakti Chandrika, books are the basis. Every day we are singing the Guru Puja. Sri Guru Charana Padma Kevala Bhakti Sadma Bandho Muhi Saudhana Mate. That is from where? From Prarthana of Narottam Das Thakur. From there his disciple Baldev Vidyabhushan. He wrote the famous Govinda Bhashya, where Govindevji himself helped him to give, because the Sri Sampradaya Vaishnavas argued that the Gaudiya Vaishnavas had no basis or the commentary, real commentary on the Brahma Sutra or the Vedanta Sutra. So Govindevji, the deities of Rupa Goswami, personally dictated the Govinda Bhashya to Baldev Vidyabhushan. And he established that Gaudiya Vaishnavism is a bona fide Vaishnava Sampradaya, where everybody else conceded. From Baldev Vidyabhushan, it came down in disciplic succession. Bhakti Vinod Thakurji, he has written so many wonderful books, over 100 books, big and small. Books are the basis. Jaiva Dharma, and in the form of Vaishnava songs, Sharanagati, Gitavali, every day we sing. I just sang the Jai Radha Madhav before every class. What is Jai Radha Madhav? It is from Bhakti Vinod Thakur's Gitavali. We just sang a few minutes, half an hour or 45 minutes ago, the Gaura Arati. Kiba Jaya Jaya, Gaura Chanda. That is also from Bhakti Vinod Thakur's Gitavali. So all these wonderful books. And then it came down in disciplic succession to Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. The Updesh Amrit of Bhakti Siddhanta, 24 instructions and so many different books. Brahma Samhita. The Brahma Samhita that we find in the bookshop, it's not by His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada, but the commentaries are by His Divine Grace Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. And of course, His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada, following in the footsteps of the Acharyas, has given us so much information about the Supreme Lord. Many people, I will conclude in a couple minutes, Prabhuji. Many people in this world, I have attended here in Chicago, different, what we call interfaith meetings. And also in 1999, I had gone to South Africa for the Parliament of World Religions in Cape Town. When I was always curious when I met different persons from different faiths, I love to listen to them, what their concept is about theism, what their concept is of God. And believe it or not, my chest would swell, you know, really nice and broad out of, you can say, good pride. That I'm so fortunate that I came in this Brahma Madhva Gaudiya Sampradaya under the shelter of Srila Prabhupada through his sincere followers. That how much information he has given us about the details about the Supreme Lord. Most of the people, even in the let's say in Islam, they say Allahu Akbar. What does it mean in Arabic? God is great. But Prabhupada used to say they don't know how great he is. As an example, which is true. His greatness is that he is even going to become the driver of Arjun. That is the greatness. He is willing to wash the feet of his friend Sudama. He is willing to carry the slippers of his father, the padukas of Nanda Maharaj. He is being controlled by every devotee in Vraj because of the prema. That is so much. We know his father's name. We know his mother's name. Many, many faiths say, oh God. And even the divine Jesus Christ, he used to say, my father in the kingdom of God. Now the kingdom of God is Vaikuntha. And he used to even use the word heaven. But most Christians have never really got into the details of that. Because Jesus Christ, according to Srila Prabhupada and Bhaktivinoda Thakur, he was a Vaishnava. He never ate meat. But most of the Christians today, they are meat eaters. Lord Buddha came. He is Sri Krishna himself. To stop hinsa, violence, killing of animals. But today, most of the Buddhists, 95% of them, they are meat eaters. So that defeats the purpose. And there's so much details that the Vaishnava Acharyas are giving about the distant land of that personality and his associates and his activities. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami's Govinda Lila Amrit. Books are the basis. Right from morning to the every hour, the Ashtakaliya Lila of Krishna. How when he wakes up, how he takes a bath, how Mother Yashoda dresses him, how he goes out with the cows, how he meets his coward friends, how at midsun they are all playing in the forest of Vrindavan, and then the coward boys, they go away and Krishna meets the gopis. The gopis have a rendezvous in the afternoon, and then when it is time, again they collect all the cows, they call them ter, that's what calling. Ter means to call. Like we have a place where Rup Goswami compiled the Bhakti Rasamna Sindhu very close to Barsana and Nandagram, known as not Kadamba Ter. So Krishna used to climb the Kadamba tree and call. Kali, Pili, Dholi, Mridangamukhi used to call out with the flute. Different tunes, and all the different cows used to gather and assemble. So like this, all those details are given. We know the names of the cows of Krishna. We know the names of all these. All these details are given. So books are the basis. Besides Bhagavad Gita, which is the opulence of the Lord, which is kind of the CV. People get attracted to the CV when you go for a job or something. So when the HR looks at your CV, it says, oh wow, a graduate from Harvard, worked at IBM. He worked this, that, and there's a long list of opulence of that person. So with that opulence, the HR department is attracted and they call, okay, you come for an interview. But when you meet that person in person and when you interact, then you'll say, oh, he's not only got that opulence of education and etc., but he's a very sweet person. So that sweetness of Sri Krishna is revealed beyond the Bhagavad Gita to Srimad Bhagavatam and many other scriptures that has been brought. Books are the basis by our acharyas. That will give us every detail. And that is what is divine grace. He slept only an hour and 2 hours. Just like the following in the footsteps of the Goswamis of Vrindavan. Nana Shastra Vicharane Nipuno Manye Sharanav Karo. Please, O six Goswamis, Loka Nam Hitakarinam Tribhuvane Manye Sharanya Karo. They wrote wonderful scriptures, not only on philosophy, but on Ras. And they gave us the information of the distant land and the distant place and the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Like this, His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada wrote over 100 books, Great books, read Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavatam, 18,000 verses, translated each and every word, and then gave purports on the Srimad Bhagavatam, Chaitanya Charitamrita, Bhakti Rasamsinda, so many wonderful books. Please take advantage of His Divine Grace's books. It's so important. And that is preaching. Preaching means it's a very important responsibility for all the book distributors also. We have to make everybody our friend, make them feel friendly. Do not impose on anybody. Because when we impose, we turn them away. But when we become a good friend, we attract them. Preachers sitting on the Vyasasana have a big responsibility, because preaching and book distribution is non-different. What we hear and what we read from Srila Prabhupada's books is what we can speak. So thank you all very much. All glories to His Divine Grace, Srila Prabhupada. All glories to Sri Sri Guru and Gauranga. All glories to Srila Prabhupada's books and this month of the book distribution month. Krishna says finally in the Bhagavad Gita, one who distributes this knowledge is very dear to me. Someone in the 67th and 68th verse, Krishna has said that. Nobody is as dear in the past, in the present or future. So that is the position. That is why Prabhupada is Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale. And we should all take advantage. Intelligent person means one should take the fullest advantage for our own benefit. That is called swartha. Swartha. Swa means self, and artha means the most important. Artha means the conclusion or the most important benefit. Swartha. So Prabhupada's books are for us, they are swa-artha. Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much, Prabhu.
Jai Shri Prabhupada. Jai Gurudev.
So the next program is the prasadam is ready outside. So please do take that. The sponsors, can you please see me here and in front of this deacon? Thank you.
Thank you.